Police have arrested 12 protesters involved with defacing the English version of the Treaty of Waitangi exhibit at Te Papa. Abseiling equipment, spray paint and a power tool were used to vandalise the wooden panel. The protest groups say the translation displayed at our National Museum is misleading. Kushla Norman reports.
Dressed like tradies in high-vis, about a dozen protesters walked into Te Papa at about midday. Their target, a wooden panel of the English version of the Treaty of Waitangi. They painted over the third article, a removal of what they say is a translation that misleads and perpetuates a dangerous lie.
99% of the people who go through Te Papa are going to not be able to understand the Te Reo Māori version, Te Tiriti o Waitangi, the only legal document, and so they're going to read the English artifact, which can be read that sovereignty was ceded, which is absolutely not true.
Te Papa's had protests before, but today's shocked staff.
It's a real balance, you know. Protest is essential in New Zealand. Museums are a site where we come together to have the really important conversations. Being able to support that is really, really important to us. Damaging things inside of the museum is a step too far.
The Te Reo and English versions have been displayed facing each other as part of a permanent exhibition since the museum opened in 1998. Panels between them highlight the differences in interpretation. Those involved in today's protests have been calling for Te Papa to take the English artefact down since 2021.
We are by far from the first people to be requesting this. In the very conception of Te Papa, they had a Māori advisory board, and we know from members of that board that the views of Māori were silenced. That's a quote.
Te Papa says it sought advice.
Look, the way that we develop exhibitions and experience and research, we actively involve and work with our communities and peoples on anything that we do. So it's that's an evolving nature. And look, we welcome the feedback and that, and to make sure that we actually can have the best experience possible.
This treaty law academic says the museum needs to rethink its display of the treaty.
I think we're now at a point where it is misleading to simply say, well, there's an English text and a Māori text and they're equivalent, or that they are of equivalent value or relevance or importance. So I think it is maybe a point where we ought to be re-evaluating the way in which Te Papa is presenting that.
Police have arrested 12 people following the protest. Two have been charged with intentional damage.
And after today's protest, of course, there's some other news late this afternoon. A claim filed against the coalition government for breaching the treaty. What more can you tell us?
That's right. This claim has been filed by a Bay of Plenty iwi, Ngāi Terangi. And it is the first legal action against this government, this coalition government, alleging a breach of the Treaty of Waitangi. And at the core of the complaint is that the iwi is saying that the coalition government's policies have been undermining the mana of Te Ao Māori. And they give some examples. For example, they say that the changing of ministry names from Te Reo to English is such a cause of complaint, as well as making public servants communicate primarily in English. Now, the iwi want this matter dealt with urgently, but the Waitangi Tribunal, they do not, or they only grant urgent hearings in exceptional circumstances. We may, though, find out in the next couple of days whether a hearing is accepted.
Kia ora, Kushla. Thank you very much.